Now for the second problem in part B, a bit more complicated voltage divider, but still a voltage divider. Okay, the first thing that you can notice here is that this is really simpler than it looks, because this combination of all four of these resistances adds together to become 1K. The two series resistors here become 2K, these become 2K, and when you add two identical 2K resistors together in parallel, you get half, and so you get 1K. So they add up to 1K, which then gives us a very simple voltage divider where you have a 1K resistor here and a 1K resistor over here. So the voltage at B must be half of that here for the 24, so the voltage at B must be equal to 12 volts. So now we know this is 12, and if that's 12, then the voltage here and here must be half of that, because again, these two resistors are identical and these two resistors are identical, so V at C must be equal to 6 volts. Now the question is, what's the current through this resistor right here? Well, the voltage at D must be the same as at C, which is 6 volts. So I and R4 will be 6 divided by 1 milliamps, or 6 milliamps. And that's basically the entire problem. So this was a little more complicated, a bit more complicated as it says, but really not much more complicated. So here's the answers for B and C, and here's the current through R4. And that's it for this solution.